Well, if I remember, looking at their pistols, they were only able to win one in their game, but take the entire series. So they usually fare quite well after.
Three up, because they don't have a lot of time to retake the site, as we see Sam already entering through. He gets domed by Poison. Now for Daps, he's probably maybe considering the post-plant scenario, getting those exit frags if they do decide to go that way. EU is going to be forced up here. Push through. Great shot there from Poise. They won't even opt in to go back the other way because they've got so much control in this link area.
A nice quick return back to the A site on that. A little bit of pressure thrown. You peel off and you always have to consider as the
Phantom. That's a lot invested into this one for sure.
Yeah.
A lot of the utility already gone as well. I think that's partially due to Zeta himself now buying a lot of the utility to opt in for the Phantom. Already off to a
big
poor start. Mitch does get stuffed there by Sam. One more push forward. Floppy does manage to find that refrag as Leaf will join him. And now the player still back site. EU's got a great angle, but is quickly answered back by Zeta. Android in a little bit of trouble. Still waiting for the Cypher to rotate back around, but Daps taking his sweet time now in a 1v2 against Leaf and Zeta. How does he bring this one home?
So far, Cloud9 executing based on power and numbers here, really making it in with a combination of utilities. Zeta goes down. Daps now to 1v1. A little tarnished on Leaf, but he's still pretty healthy here.
Daps, gotta check that. Oh, he the second guesses himself. He's just like, I got too many angles to worry about. Not planted. Mitch now gonna do that. Shock darts are gonna take him down to 76. He is quite low, but let's see how Cloud9 handle this pressure.
Retake arrow's already been used. Let's see how they get back into this one coming over from the other side. It's gonna be Sam as he makes his way to. This is gonna be the 5 retake on 4. A little hurt for Leaf, a little hurt for Mitch, but they have good positioning for this. There's the running back down, and they're gonna keep going.
Oh, Tex is now gonna be forcing that issue against Data 1v3. They're gonna potentially look through the smoke, just the shots. He's just trying to get the angle on the spike, but if you recall, Mitch had to move a little to the left as he was planning it. Ray's not gonna connect. I think the comms were there's a player kind of lurking around there. Daps does end up getting tagged, but the spike is still nowhere near. Decision from Android, it's problematic, still is going to be dealt with. Now a counter hunter through here from EU, just trying to find someone. I think he may have gotten a tag. Now the spike's going down.
Daps with a great 1v1 trade there to drop Poise. That was pivotal for regaining A control ground. They're going to make sure that's safe. The spike going down now as they try to fight it. Mitch able to...
Him has the shock darts. There is the last one. They're going to push the smoke, play together, play within their... You see the rotations come fast for Cloud9. They've managed to convince NRG. It's the important hit. And Lee finds a pick. He does get traded. That was bound to happen. It's going to be the B hit. This is a little bit troublesome, though, because Energy can react to this fast. They're already here fighting with Cloud9. Like we've identified, play up close and personal. They push two members back, and Mitch is going to be the sacrificial lamb as he decides to back away slowly. He's managed to make his way out, and now Energy on the site. Floppy thinking about the rotation through Garage. Mitch gets spot out, but it's a quick counter for Mitch. He somehow survives with the frag. Still, they're coming in. They're dominating. Texas down with the up and the Blade Storm. Down to the 2v2, Floppy on the flank, and you're seeing EU, he's kind of cognizant of it, not really. Looks over, just down to the 1v1, the spray is good. For something explosive to get into the site, Sam's waiting with the charge. He's gonna find one, a quick trade, but still, Android's there, laying in wait right outside. That's the spike called. NRG, come, bring the cavalry. We've got the control, but Leaf there on the flank, you see Android. He's understanding that something's going on the opposite side, waiting for it to subside. Leaf's going to find that one, but still, that's not spike secure. One player logs, one player plat, and the plat player, EU, will take him down. Floppy now alongside Zeta, looking for the positioning down long, just down to the heavy shoulders
here. You always have to remember the game of Valorant can change between the 4th, 5th, 7th, 8th, whatever round right between there. When everybody's getting their ultimates, here we are into the site.
Oh, they'll find one here for Android. Still the shock darts are trying to delay the plant. They're in! Oh, goodness! Poise is going to get so much value from that dismiss. They'll find an upgrade on the ground as well. It's a 3v2 somehow, some way. And through the gravity well, they will plant that spike. Floppy down to 6. He will sacrifice his life if necessary. Just to make sure that these players can play for the body peaks. Just down to Daps. This...
great camera. Look at that, seeing him from the top. He hasn't shot anybody. He's just picking him out. He's able to get one with a showstopper to start, though. His ultimate start flying left and right.
Oh, wow. You find so much value, but still, boys, it's going to play off the dismiss. Beautifully done. Just down to leave the spray. Not enough to finish off Android. Too close for comfort, but energy. Once again, Cloud9 thinking about a potential A hit. Wondering if this is trying to be some sort of sold fake, but Energy Android still survives. Even the blast back. How does he get another? The gravity well helps him out finally. The delayed blast back from the grave. Boys finds one, pushing up onto Daps through short. He wraps around from long. Now text early on the site. You highlighted this. You like to get in position early to not...
Great positioning by Mitch. At least one, two, or some eco damage to start, but it's going to be a Spectre versus a quick flick Vandal.
Oh, Mitch. Oh, Mitch. Oh, Mitch! Tex does his homework, and he passes the test, too.
That's going to be one shot. Did you get the fake on there? Coming out. And Mitch gets the better of him.
How? I mean, we identified this as the head-to-head, but it always seems like Mitch is good for one. That is so key! Leap also good for one as well. Players backside, they're trying to force the issue. Next finds Leap, hunting down the other duelist, will not find...
Holding, Poppy holding, Zeta holding, they're all holding great angles. Boys,
really just really solid positioning from Energy. Now that we move on to this half, Cloud9 still don't really like to let up that aggressive game. There's a utility frag onto Daps. Now Mitch is holding down long. They walk back into him backwards. What is happening? There's a player garage. Mitch, are you good for more? There's a camera and it's so nerdy. Spots out two players, but do you anticipate EU? No, you don't. Zeta with the Owl Drone just sending a couple of pre-fire shots. 4v3 now. Taking a 4v2 as we find another. Just down to Sam and Android. Now the spike's being planted. Poise in a great position to push. They don't need to wait. They don't need to stall. They can force the issue, and Cloud9 winning the pistol is key to continue their success.
Simo, what we just witnessed.
See the gravity well and a beautiful cage. That's, of course, the attacker cage. First fight, like you said, for Tex does not go his way. But Leaf pushing up down long gets punished by Android. Likely a curveball out and then into the engagement. And now they fight as
well. No way.
Oh my goodness. Boys and Floppy in tandem. Just down to EU. He's in the wrong time. He's in a tough spot. They know where he is. There's the push forward for Mitch, but Floppy with the backstab.
I'm blue. Here they go.
Oh, the recon bolt's gonna find so many players. Three. EU still finds one. That's deep on a crucial frag.
Oh,
Tex with another.
Daps
with the third. What is happening on this eco? Just down to Floppy in a 1v2. Definitely possible. But the spike wasn't planted this whole time. And now it's just down to EU. Opens the nose. Has no ammo. And the clutch comes for Floppy.
See, they've got the Cosmic Divide, the Hunter's Fury. They've got a lot of tools at their disposal. And with two players on the flank, EU not able to stop them, this is also starting to slip away.
I think Mitch still has a pretty good camera here in sight. They can decide to use it. It just got taken out. Now they head in. Ulti's flying left and right, Leaf.
A little too close for comfort as the Showstopper will take out the clone, but not take out Daps, down to 8. Players for the long side are starting to push forward. Boys and Mitch will fall just down to Floppy and Zeta, and they're looking to force the issue. NRG. They're very exposed. Now the comms come in from Mitch. They're C. I'm going to need some assistance. Maybe not. As Mitch finds one once more. Zeta with another through the cage. Can't control the spray through the log. Mitch is still somehow alive. Does finally get dealt with. And now Leap becomes a part of the problem. Som will trade that one out, but it's a 2v2. The spike's still not planted. They need to get it down if they have to bring a threat over to Cloud9. Smoke goes down. That means Cloud9 are halted for now. Sprays come through. Spike's still not planted. Som is the one holding it, just trying to bait them out to push them forward. Shots good for boys.
A lot of these shots and confidence coming up and energy feeling there. They didn't have control of the site. Not somewhere you can plant the spike. And great job by Cloud9 to always make that feel like it's somewhere they don't have control of. Energy doesn't have control of. So Tech's going to see what he can do with the Bladestorm as he goes selling some knives door to door.
Oh, boys. Gets shut down, but Mitch, trusty Mitch, does end up getting traded by Android, making sure his trusty duelist is not left alone to his own devices. But there's just a whole slew of utility stuck there in A-Link. Floppy does find one through that spraying through. Now the 3v3 with a very injured Android. Doesn't have any utility to heal himself up. No Sage, of course, available either. Bring his health back to fruition. Data, the Guardian flanking around, just trying to cause a ruckus. Make them a little confused where Cloud9 might be coming through. Floppy does trade out lead, pushed in. Android's down. He was low already, but now it all falls onto Somm. Match point here. Somm needs to get involved. There's going to be the jiggle through the wall, but pushing forward, it's Floppy. Somm, you can get it done. Zeta doesn't push it to half, but that's the map for Cloud9.
C9 really putting the pressure on everywhere they can. They haven't even really played a push-up style to cause energy to turtle. They've allowed energy in. They're coming back into the facility and find in the site. Let's see what they can do against C9 now.
Oh, Zeta holding lane. Mitch as well gonna push through the smoke. Players are already on the site, but they were waiting for the perfect timing for the players to cross in. Not even a single player will fall. Doors close and the retake will have to come in. Cloud9 is fast. It does look like they're kind of ready and laying in wait. Stars will go down. Poise on site has to share. Looking to caterpillar his way in, and Android and Somm not letting the rest of the team push through. Leaf now on the opposite front. That's a player down, but only one frag comes in. Zeta having to reload the clip. A solid hold here for energy, but doesn't play a factor though, as they are going to start to group up over towards A. Zeta with a pick onto Tex. So now the push down cap's not going to be an impact. There's going to be another ultimate there for Android. Shots not quite connecting for Leaf. As Android takes him down, Boy's just trying to inch closer and closer. Does he have the angle? Does he have the shot? Has to connect on the turret instead, and down to 31. As the rest of Cloud9 have started to join the front. Push, retake. Mitch leading that charge, has the turret. He wants to bait out a peek. Android, the timing of this curveball has to be key. There's the swing, and now Mitch on the retreat. At least one will fall. There's the turret to give him a little bit of an opportunity to body peek. Does get traded for Android. Floppy. Poise has also fallen, re-peaking heaven. EU just trying to provide some space. Back away. Ooh. And shots won't be good for Floppy. Oh, yeah. And now, despite finding that frag, no Riv, this a big push over to A. The spike was over towards B in tiles near spawn, so they have to rush it back over. And this lockdown makes that a challenge, because the timing of the spike getting there not going to be enough to secure it. There's going to be the Hunter's Fury to try to take out the lockdown. It will end up falling, but a lot of players fall as a result. Hunter's Fury finds another. This eco is slowly starting to come into the hands of Cloud9, and boys! Finds three on the Thrifty, a solid. Gonna delay it even further. Mitch, how many players is he good for? Good for one. Still Floppy now there as well. Android manages to find the frag, but they need to plant Leaf. Now starting to chase them down. EU is just holding the gate, just trying to hold them back. But Android, you'll get the credits, you'll get the spike point, but that's all you're gonna get. Cloud9 lead by two.
Good mention on the alt point. That is the run.
Get planted. Still, some of these ultimates are available for energy if they do decide to use them. That's going to be the Blaze updraft over. I like that from Boys. Very unexpected for energy. Now the push in. They're looking to get active on this eco. Force them back. Oh my goodness. This is our site. This is our turf. Daps in EU. Last player standing. Daps though on the flank. He is being spotted out here by Zeta. Now EU. He's not.
Is it going to work?
Yeah, he still manages to get away. Unfortunately, can't find anything as there is a player that falls. But it's a beautiful recall bolt from Zeta. He spots out three. It'll only capitalize onto one so far. Here's the lockdown we highlighted. No shock darts available as Zeta has already used some of that clear utility. So Cloud9 wants to fight. 4 seconds remaining. Not a lot of time left before players start to get detained. They will back away just in time. Spike still ticking. Three left for Cloud9. Boy swaps to the Phantom, looking to get active. Drop the smoke. Leaf with one. Crossfire's good. Another. It's up to Daps, and it's good from Leaf.
Yeah, this C9 squad is putting up some numbers versus teams. But the only falter we're seeing is once they come to close out the maps. And they did the same thing versus Envy. A lot of people questioned if Envy came to play that day. But I think we have to just question, is Cloud9 Blue coming to play even harder? Are they that hungry right now? We're seeing these plays from them that look quite unstoppable. And the tests are being told right here. Cosmic Divide is up. Still have the Operator for Poise. Let's see how they hold this one.
Oh, the running headshot. Oh, they fight three just in succession like that. EU's just trying to hold on to the post-plant Hunter's Fury. That's another one that comes into his pocket. And it's a great round from Energy.
Spike, and he gets Spike.
Oh, one away now. God. They're just feeding him. He's a chunky boy. Nice and full. Gets a pick. He can use that for a post-plan hold if he wants. I mean, I'd probably argue you want to hold on to that as we see the fight now start to break out. Mob shots! That's going to be Android down. He'll have to run it back, but at what cost? His life. Hunter's Fury now clearing out the wine cellar. It's Leafier catching the flank on the dab. Still the players in A-Main. Smokes keep going down. Boys going in with the shorty. He'll be taken down. And still now two players peek one at a time.
They baited him into the site. Hook, line, and sinker. Great job by Somp, too, to start cleaning up. The rounds like this in the middle as well are good for confidence. Get the blood flowing.
Kind of playing into factor for this last round. Fortunate that Cloud9 kind of sniff things out. They do their checks early in mid, and nobody is there, so they'll rush onto the B side here for NRG, and really, it's been a lot of eight hits. Wow! As the door is closing, that might be the door closing on NRG's round. As Tex is down, Android playing the snail. That's his role play here. Pushing forward is the opposing Jet, and Neef will be able to deal with that accordingly. Dap just trying to play on the site.
Oh, no.
The last player standing with the spike planted. Trying to figure out where he's located. They got him dead to rights. An 8-4. They've switched up some of their Killjoy setups here, a little bit more towards the door, but Cloud9 playing for the window. Boys has to reload. He's quickly traded before EU finds two on the way out. Now with Mitch kind of coming in from heaven, Naps was almost in trouble. Android still manages to help him out with the turn. The sixth man in the lobby finds a frag.
Positions that they need. The C9 tries to suss out what could be next, and Android's going to find the first of that cavalry. C9 up through tree.
Yeah, this is going to be problematic. Tex is already looking to peek heaven. Wants those shots! And like a fly swatter, Boys is down, but Zeta on the flank. That's now the op out of commission. Still a 2v2. One player that gets tagged by the recon bolt is out of commission as well. And Somm on this defensive half has started to look so good as they find the bonus that they needed. Energy are trailing by one. Prior rounds, but this time they're sending their efforts up mid. This is a very interesting crossfire because on the opposite side is Somm. Hunter's Fury used to try to get some early intel. A pick does end up falling in the pocket. Somm, who was lurking in the shadows, does find a trade for his team. And a very injured voice, which I'm imagining may have come from the Hunter's Fury. And another one comes in. The Owl Drone's going to spot out two players mid. There's the swing. Mitch somehow will survive. And another
Mitch
up with these picks. Now it's Daps and EU. There's Daps holding the off angle in the tree. There's the... Not the recon bolt. And a shock dart spray. Not enough to do so. Lockdown is down, and as they're trying to play for the lockdown, push in, Somm finds two, Zeta gets traded, Mitch has to wait outside, got his keys in his car, now he'll decide to go back in. They're defusing the spike. This round is as good as NRG's. What a hold there from three. That. And Leaf gets his as we now move on to the next round. Empress popped, and just like that, the Reyna wakes up from a nightmare. A quick trade there for Mitch and the lockdown to secure the A site, but Somm very deep back site. Once more, we see that same adaptation to the round. Prior, Somm, he holds them off as the duelists start to lurk throughout the map. It's a 2v3.
See what they can get. Floppy and Astral. Cosmic Divide goes straight up towards heaven. That's going to block off everything towards the window. Let's see if they can get through now. It's broke. Oh. break the glass after it is, but I don't think the gun get through, so they could ability it. But he's waiting for Android. Quick shot to the face. Somebody coming through. Beta tries to tag him, and it is going to be the push. They're going to hear that drone going up mid, I believe, from their trek towards the B main here. Do they actually want this without knowing too much? Tex is going to be there. They're going to get the help. Now Mitch is able to drop Tex in this firefight, and it is chaos in B main, Simo.
They still find Android and Tex in the process. All that's left is EU with 70 HP. This is about to get bloody. Do you save it for this round? Do you use it this round? Do you save it for the next? How do you close this map out of your energy? Cosmic Divide, I think, is likely going to be placed here. You see some of those stars start to come through. What ultimate ends up getting used? They've got a couple of upgrades as well. Zeta with one. What do you plan on using? Cosmic Divide, it's a little bit too late, NRG, as Cloud9 tie us up.
They're trying to squeeze out what they can and find these rounds.
Oh, EU. Legolas will be proud, still connecting with those shots. The spray through Android opens up with poise. Considering the economic disadvantage, this could be good to find that weapon upgrade off the floor. Mitch, though, does find one cross-map, and this B site is wide open. Alarm bot as well in that choke point. He needs to hold on to this while the rest of the team start to funnel through. You're seeing them start to funnel in from B. The Owl Drone is going to be used. Didn't spot him, but he still played for it. Now the spray! Mitch! He finds two. They line up for him. Tech's last player standing, Riv. That hurts so much if you're NRG.
Round. And those stars are a 3K for Mitch as he comes up very, very big. And the Mitch and Daps head-to-head, we have been seeing Mitch just play out of his mind. 24... 18 and 4 right now, putting up huge numbers as the sense.
So much from energy, that hurts quite a bit. Player on the lurk. Thief catches the cross. Now smokes go down. And they find a pick for free. Android from range, and he's gone. The run it back is out. That is such a crucial piece of the pie that needs to be eaten for energy to win this round. 3v5 is where we sit now, Riv.
This becomes tough. A great control of mid coming in from Poise, from Leaf. Zeta was able to waltz through B main alone, all because of the lockdown you called in the beginning by Mitch to start us off. C9 knew exactly what they wanted to do this round without falter. Now they're flying around grabbing kills here from the view of Tex. Only continues to do so for Cloud9 Blue. Energy still in this with one more round to tie it and bring it into overtime.
Let's get a lay of the land here for